This weekend marked the annual White House Correspondents' Dinner, where the President of the United States gets to let his hair down. Literally.
I understand, second term, need a burst of new energy, try some new things, and then my team and I talked about it. We were willing to try anything, so we borrowed one of Michelle's tricks.
But within minutes of the president delivering a mix of self-deprecating humour and a stream of zingers aimed at the media, one individual just didn't get the joke. At 11:04 p.m. Saturday night, Sarah Palin took to Facebook. Yuck it up, media and polls. While America is buried in taxes and a fight for our rights, the permanent political class in D.C. dresses up and has a prom to make fun of themselves. Mrs. Palin, clearly incandescent with rage, followed up her comments on Facebook with the following tweet. That White House correspondents' dinner was pathetic. The rest of America is out there working our asses off while these DC ass clowns throw themselves a nerd prom. Now, I could remind Mrs. Palin that included in her reference to rectal comedians are her husband and her daughter, both of whom enjoyed dressing up and attending the self-same event in the past. But addressing the facts with her would be a pointless exercise. The truth is that these comments mark her miserable decline from hopelessly mindless vice presidential candidate to now a near non-entity. What's left is a smouldering bitterness that America once again proved too smart and too discerning to tolerate her meretricious bile. You see, unlike Snooki and The Situation, who are her peers in the world of reality television, they've successfully extended their brands into perfume and power shakes. But Mrs. Palin is now found slumped alone among the discarded rubbish of a CPAC conference, her only accompaniment, the deep well of bitterness and jealousy that now mark her character. And yet, while she rails against that dinner on Saturday night, one of the speakers may well have stumbled upon something that she is perfectly qualified to do.
Incidentally, you may not know this, but Wayne LaPierre is merely the executive vice president of the NRA. Which begs the question, how freaking crazy do you have to be the actual president of the NRA?
Mrs. Palin, the NRA looks forward to receiving your application.